They had us sit in an interrogation room. There's a camera in the corner, and Special Agent Huckle was sit in front of us, and Special Agent Lindsay Coulter would sit next to him, and then Samantha Adam would sit next to her. Okay? And the Special Agent, Supervisor Special Agent Huckle would show us a still image of a CCTV, a picture from printed out from a CCTV of the day after my brother got beaten up. And he said, look, your brother is okay. We asked the supervisor, we're like, why are you being selective about showing those pictures of the next day and not the day of the beating? He said, I'm not being selective, and he doesn't answer the question. He just brushes over. He's like, I'm not being selective. I'm just showing you what's on the camera. Okay. We asked if they had interviewed the inmate that came forward about seeing the correctional officers beating up my brother and essaying him inside the jail. Special Agent Lindsay Coulter gets frustrated. She said it's not her job. Did you interview him? She said, did you interview him? She's asking us if we interviewed him. Did you find him? They had a prosecutor from the Department of Justice on the phone. And as soon as we start asking these questions, Supervisor Special Agent Huckle gets frustrated. He takes that guy off the phone. He tells him, I know you're busy, blah, 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 blah. Okay, and he hangs up the phone with him. And then we ask him, did you x-ray my brother's arm and legs? He says no. We ask him, why did you not x-ray his arm and leg? He said, this is not a cross-examination, and he ends the meeting. We ask him, when my brother tells you that he was essayed inside the jail, did you physically check? Did you take him to the hospital and follow procedure? They never did. So when looking at this FBI agent through this investigation, she's providing a cover for the jail. She's covering up for the jail. The fact that she never x-rayed his arm or x-rayed his leg. And at one point, the supervisor, Special Agent Huckle, would admit that he saw on the CCTV that correctional officers carried my brother unconscious from one cell into another cell. Now, this is consistent with the inmate that came forward. I have a recording. I posted it on the page that my brother was beaten up, carried from one cell into another, unconscious. This is exactly what the other inmate said. Now, I'll tell you why they never x-rayed his arm and leg. My brother, on the day of the accident, on the vehicle accident, he was helicoptered to the hospital. They did a full body CT scan. If you were to x-ray his arm and leg today, you're going to find compound and fracture from the beating he got by a correctional officer on May 24. They refused to x-ray his arm and leg. Because the minute you x-ray his arm and leg, you're going to see, all you have to do is compare the x-ray from May 24 to April 7, and you're going to find the difference. They think we're stupid. They think they can just play around with the investigation. Supervisor Huckle ends the meeting. He says this is not a cross-examination. He ends the meeting. Now, we found out about the jail board meetings. That there are jail board meetings that are open to the public, and if you have a problem inside the jail, you can go to these meetings. They're public meetings, open to the community. Every 2 months they hold a meeting, and you can go into these meetings and you can talk about what's happening to your loved ones inside the jail. And that's exactly what we did. Back in December, there was a public meeting for a jail board. We went in. Now, when we went in, we found out that the jail board members are the same individuals committing the atrocities. It's the same individuals. Okay? It's the jail board members is the superintendent. Okay? The superintendent, Colonel Peter Molitas. The Sheriff Glenn Hill. The Chief of Police, Chief Peter Newsham. Amy Ashworth, Commonwealth Attorney Amy Ashworth. Now, these are the same people implicated in what they're doing to my brother. Am I really going to expect these people to really look into abuse that my brother is getting inside the jail? My brother has been in solitary confinement for a whole year. Now, when we tell Commonwealth Amy Ashworth my brother has been in solitary confinement, she looks the other way. As a matter of fact, she's happy that my brother is getting beaten up, solitary confinement for a year, because she doesn't want my brother to take the stand. Okay? She's protecting a police officer that lied. If my brother takes the stand, she's going to end up going to jail. My brother has exonerating evidence, and he has evidence that show Amy Ashworth knew about the police officer falsifying, yet she moved forward with the case and protected the police officer. Now, what do you think is going to happen when my brother takes the stand? 100% she's going to end up getting sued and going to jail. So when we tell him my brother has been in solitary confinement for a whole entire year, my brother got beaten up on the hand of correctional officer, she shows us the same picture that the FBI is showing us. The picture after, the day after my brother got beaten up. Now, Commonwealth Amy Ashworth, why are you being selective about showing us the picture from the CCTV and not the day after, and not the day of the beating? The actual beating. Now, Commonwealth Attorney, we understand this game. You're looking the other way because you don't want my brother to take the stand. Because if he takes the stand, he's going to show his evidence, and you're going to end up going to jail for a long time because it shows that you protected this police officer. And unfortunately, this is the jail board member. She's a jail board member, and she looks the other way when there's abuse. And the sad part is, she's not only doing it to my brother, she's doing it to a lot of other people. And I'm not just saying that. I say that because I have inmates that reach out, call, I record their voice, and I've taken their voices to the FBI, to the Department of Justice, that they're telling me that they're getting beaten up inside the jail, they're getting stripped naked, they're being denied medical, they're getting essayed, and then when we give it to the Commonwealth Amy Ashworth, she looks the other way because she wants to prosecute these individuals. She wants them so badly hurt inside the jail that when she gives them a plea deal, they're gonna be begging for a plea deal. Or they're so badly hurt that they're not gonna be able to take the stand. So that way she can just prosecute them the way she sees fit. It's a conflict of interest that she's a Commonwealth attorney. Now, that's the Commonwealth attorney. Now, the Chief of Police, Peter Newsham, he's a jail board member. Now, when we tell the Chief of Police that my brother is in solitary confinement, my brother is getting beaten up inside the jail on the hand of correctional officer, my brother is getting essayed, he looks the other way. And he looks the other way because he doesn't want my brother to take the stand. Because if my brother takes a stand, he's going to testify against his police department. My brother has evidence that his police officer falsified the statement on a police report. If my brother takes a stand, that chief of police has a lawsuit on his hands, so he doesn't want my brother to make it to the stand. So he wants my brother abused. He wants my brother deteriorate. So he looks the other way. Now, the superintendent, these are his correctional officers. See, all these individuals, it's a conflict of interest to have these members on the jail board. The jail board, the jail is policing itself. Now, the superintendent, Superintendent Peter Molitas. It's a conflict of interest to have the superintendent look into the abuse inside his jail. These are his correctional officers. And what's happening in this jail is there are correctional officers that have been there for 10, 15 years. They walk around with their cell phone. The superintendent is not going to be able to get rid of them, even if he wanted to. They've got their cell phone inside the jail. Every time a correctional officer beat up an inmate, they got their cell phone and recording. Now, you don't think these correctional officers, if you reprimand them or get rid of them, they've got so much dirt on this jail that they're going to shut down this jail? How is a superintendent going to hold these correctional officers accountable if they've been there for 10, 15 years? The superintendent can't hold them accountable even if he wanted to.